into this place. Welcome into this broken vessel. You desired to abide in the praises of your people. So we lift our hands as we lift our heart, as we offer up these praises to your name. Welcome into this place. Welcome into this broken vessel. You desire to abide in the praises of your people. So we lift our hands as we lift our hearts, as we offer up these praises to your name. Jesus, be the center of my joy. Jesus, be the center of my joy. All that's good and perfect comes from you. You're my heart and my contentment, hope for all I do. Jesus, you're the center of my joy. When I lost my direction, you're the perfect thing in life. You are my shining star, the my light and bright hope. Jesus, you're the center of my joy. All that's good and perfect, it comes from you. Yeah, you're the heart of my contentment, hope for all I do. Jesus, you're the center of my joy. Jesus, you're the center of my joy. Jesus, you're the center of my joy. Thank you, Lord. Father, in Jesus' name, we bless you. We glorify you. We give you glory, we give you honor, and we give you praise. Have your way in our hearts. Have your way in our mind, in our soul, in our spirit. You get the glory, you get the honor, and you get all the praise out of our lives. We thank you and we bless you. We glorify your name. You still remain to be the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. And besides you, O God, there is and there can and there won't ever be another God, because you are the center of my joy. Thank you, Lord, in Jesus' name. Amen, amen, and amen. Welcome to our broadcast. We thank you. My name is Frank Bodie. We welcome to you this broadcast entitled, Do You Want to Be Made Well? Do you want to be made well? Not so much do you want to be made rich, but that's still a good thing, but do you want to be made well? Your health, your spirit man, your soul, and those attributes are more important than the outer appearance. And the question again, do you want to be made well? And we take this from the scriptures in the Bible when Jesus confronted the man when he was stricken by sickness for 38 years. And Jesus confronted him and asked him that question by saying to him, do you, young man, do you want to be made well? And that's a question that he asked all of us, you know, as we observe and as we look at areas of our lives, and we don't ever have to feel as though that we're helpless, because we always have God. We always have Jesus Christ in our life, who is able to empower us and to make us well. And Jesus confronted the man that was sick for 38 long years. That's a long time to be sick with this type of sickness and just stricken for a long time. And still he had people that was there that was able to bring him to the water when the water was stirred. The angel stirred the water in order for people to get into this water, to be made well, to be healed, to be set free, and to be delivered. And because this man never had the opportunity to be one of the first, in fact, the first to get into the water, someone always beat him to the punch of getting in the water. When the water was stirred, someone always beat him to the punch. And he just laid there and laid there by the pool, laid there and just waited and waited and waited. And that's how it is with some of us today. We're still waiting for somebody to do something for us. And there's nothing wrong with somebody doing something for us. But sometimes there are things that we can do for ourselves that we sometimes wait on other people to do for us. The Bible says, greater is he that is in you than he that is in the world. And so there are some things that you can do that is it's supernatural power that God empowers us to do things that we never thought that we can do. And so this man was looking at natural strength to get him to the place where he needed to get to. He was looking for people to get him to this pool in order for him to be healed, in order for him to be delivered. And sometime when we come to the point of waiting on people to do something for us, sometime it's not going to come out right. Sometime it's not going to happen, especially the way we want it to happen. When we wait on people to do certain things for us, and maybe it was in the equation for no one to do anything for this man anyways. Maybe Jesus just didn't want anyone to do anything for this man so that he could simply let this man know that I'm God and who God is. And so that God was able to come into his life and to be his all in all. And there may be some things in your life too. There may be some things that you're dealing with in your life too, that it appears that you may have been looking at other people to do for you. And it appears that it seems as though everyone has come up short. Like the commercial, every time I turn around, it says it comes up peanuts. And every time we turn around, we want somebody to help us to do a certain thing, it seems as though that it don't come out the way we want it to come out. And just maybe it could be that God have had his hands on it because he don't want anyone to be able to help you in that particular thing. Because he wants to get the glory, he wants to get the honor, and he wants to get the praise. Sometimes we look and we come to the point in life when we feel as though that people are our all in all. But no, I know that Jesus is my help, and my help and our help, it comes from the Lord. All of our help comes from the Lord, and we need to know that, that God is not going to let anything happen to you today that which that he would not allow it to happen. And if he didn't allow it to happen, then it ain't going to happen. So don't be tripping. Don't be bugging out, because God is still in control. And so this man was still waiting on people to come to help him, to get him from point A, from point B. I think, if I'm not mistaken, it said 38 long years. It was 38 years that this man was waiting for someone, somebody to help him to get from where he was laying down at into this pool when the water was stirred. And it seems like sometimes some of us were waiting, and there's nothing wrong with getting help from people. There's nothing wrong with people helping us to do certain things, but you and I, we can't expect folk to do everything for us. We can't expect people to do the things that we know that we're supposed to do ourselves. And so God didn't allow anyone to help this man. And I believe that it's just, there's some things that is happening even in your life that you're looking for just this thing to happen. You're looking for this loan to come forward. You're looking for these things to come forth in the mail. And so it seems as though, because what you're looking for, that nothing else makes you happy. Nothing else can go forward until somebody that you're looking forward to bring the good, so to speak. But you need to be able to realize that who you're looking for, who you're waiting for, is not the actual person who you should be waiting for. Hello, somebody. Really, if you, in actuality, you should be waiting on the Lord, waiting on God. Now, waiting don't necessarily mean waiting, which is sitting down in a chair and twiddling your fingers and twiddling your thumbs, or basically just sitting there not doing anything. Waiting means that you will get all of the required information that you need to get for today. Don't worry about tomorrow, but focus on today. The Bible says that how much more does he take care of the sparrows? And if he takes care of the sparrows, how much more will he take care of you? So don't focus on tomorrow. Focus on today. And when we focus on today, we realize that God can get the fullness out of each and every one of us. So it's important that we realize that God can download information in us so that we don't have to just wait for something that basically may take 38 years. So that we can wait. We don't want to wait for this and wait for that while there's so much more to be done. There's so much more that need to be taken care of. And if we can grasp that, we can begin to go forward into the things that God would have us to do. And I believe that once you start doing what you know that God will begin to start having you to do, that the thing that you've been waiting for a long, long time, 38 years, 16 years, 12 years, 8, 4, 3, 1 year, 1 day, that then the very thing will happen. Sometimes just looking at the clock. And looking at the clock, basically, sometimes it seems like time moves so slow. So twiddling your thumb like this man when he was laying there, he was sort of just laying there waiting for this something to happen. And it seemed like time will never move forward. I remember when I was in school years ago, and I would always be looking at the clock so we can have lunch, so we can get out the classroom and go play ball, and just looking at the clock. And it seemed like the clock never moved. It seemed like that minute hand never moved, simply because I was just focusing on that clock. But had I focused on the other things that was around me and did those things that I knew that I was supposed to do, that hand, if I look right back at the clock After I did that work, the hands, I would have noticed that the time would have moved. And time would have moved. And so we want to make sure that we just don't wait for people to do things for us. But we know that we can continue to do. That's the number point. That's a very important point for each and every one of us. And when we do this, we need to make sure that we're doing what we're doing with the right attitude. The attitude plays a very important role as you as a man of God, you as a woman of God. Your attitude is so important, because the attitude has a lot to do with getting everything, all the nutrients, all the supplements, all of the vitamins, every type of spirituality into that very thing that you're working at. Realize that you're assigned to that through God. And because you're assigned through that thing that God is telling you to do for today, there's so much spirituality in it. You don't just have to be in a church on Sunday listening to a preacher, a teacher, or whomever preach. God can speak to you through your everyday, daily task, but you got to have the right attitude in order for God to speak. And as your attitude is right toward God, God begins to speak to you in so many different ways that you can ever imagine. He begins to minister to you. He begins to let you know even about the thing that you may have been waiting for 38 years. Don't you see that waiting has a lot to do with waiting on God and being able to move according to God and then having the right attitude? And as your attitude begins to be right, as your attitude begins to be focused upon the things of God, having the right attitude, which is the fruits of the Spirit, love, joy, peace, patience. And sometimes we don't always operate in those areas. But what we can do, because we don't always operate, we know who does operate. God operates in those areas. He operates 24/7 in the fruit of the Spirit. And so we can always reach out and get those things from God. We can ask the Father, Abba, Father, Lord, I need to have more patience. Lord, I need to show more love. Lord, I need to show more long suffering. So whatever you need to ask God for, believe me, God got it. And not only does God got it, God will give it to you if you ask for it, if you have the right motives. And because your motives are correct, because you want to be a blessing to the body of Christ, God will give you the very things that you ask him for so you can bless the body of Christ. And so here we got to understand that having the right attitude is so important today. It is so important today, because people begin to see the Christ that's inside of you, with you having the Christ inside of you, you having the right attitude. When people see Christ inside of you and they see you with the right attitude, then people are able to be drawn to you. Really, it's not you that they're being drawn to, but it's the Christ that live inside of you because you got the right attitude. Do you want to be made well? Do you want to be made well? Simply starts with you being patient with yourself. Being patient with the things that's right in front of you. You don't have to get in a car, get in a plane, get in a boat, get in a helicopter or whatever have you, and go to another geographical location because things around you here aren't working accordingly. But you can trust God. Today, you can start trusting God. Today, you can start believing in God. Today, you can start pulling on God, pulling on the things of God. It's by faith, it is impossible to please God. By faith, without faith, it's impossible to please God. So when we start operating in faith in God, then God begins to be pleased. And because he's now being pleased, he's now able to give us the things that we ask for, because we know we're asking him by faith. That's the key word. Key word is faith. I heard a man say not too long ago that we have money, and when you and I have money, we're able to go to the store to buy certain things. Well, faith is the same thing as money. You see, faith is spiritual, And money is a physical thing. Money and faith is equivalent to one another, because faith with God will give us the very things that we need. And so money, tangible money that we can feel, that we can touch, will also get us, if we go to the store and purchase whatever, we can get those things. So again, faith and money are the same. Faith and money are the same. Money is the spirit, money is the physical type, but faith is a spiritual type. So we need to understand that you can get many things that you possibly can get from God, but you gotta ask through faith. You gotta believe it through faith, because your faith moves God. And there's things that you want, and you won't be able to receive them within your own natural strength, simply because you're believing, you think that you gotta do something to get it, but all you gotta do is ask with faith. You receive not because you ask not. Now it's time to believe now. Believe God for those things that you know that He's placed inside of you. Believe God for those things that you know that He put your name on it, and it's been waiting for you. And God's been waiting for you to open your mouth and to ask Him for those things. Faith comes by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. Faith, believe God. And so Jesus questioned the man and said to the man, do you want to be made well? And the man basically was somewhat dumbfounded. He didn't really have the faith that he really should have had. But Jesus was saying to the man, listen, I'm not asking you what you've been doing. Because Jesus asked him, do you want to be made well? And the man said to him, every time I try to get inside the water over there, somebody beat me. And Jesus said, listen, what I'm asking you don't have nothing to do with what you are talking about right now. I'm asking you this from my own lips. Do you want to be made well? And that's the question, not looking at any and every other thing that you've experienced, whether good or bad. But I'm just saying to you, don't look at those things that you've experienced in the past. But the question is today, November 1st, 2018, right around 2:15 or 2:20 right now, 2:30. The question is right now, do you want to move into a different zone? And that is a zone with your faith in God. See, enough now having faith in people. Enough now having faith in yourself. Enough now having faith in things. But it's time today, November 1st, 2018, your faith being placed in the one that can move mountains in your life. So not the reason why you weren't able to get results is because your faith wasn't in the one that can give you those results. And that is, God is able to do more abundantly above all that you can imagine, you can ever think of, to do or want or have in your whole life. So faith right now, channel yourself right now, channel your faith on God. Channel your faith in believing that God is who He said He is. That you're able now to have faith in God. That's the key, faith in God. And if you're not saved, you can be saved right now. You can give your life to God by faith. See, everything that you do when it comes to the Bible, to God, it's through faith. It starts with faith and it ends with faith. And it can't change. It can't be no other way. Sometimes we feel different ways, and we feel as though now our consequences or circumstances or situations are changing. No, 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 no. Hey, like Paul said in the book of Galatians, who bewitched you, Galatians? You first started out getting saved, And so now why are you moving toward a different realm of as far as trying to say how you must be saved? You got saved through your faith, and guess what? You move from faith to faith, from glory to glory. Hey, you asked God and God delivered you through faith. He healed you through faith. He set you free through faith. Hey, you got a ticket to heaven through faith, and it's still going to keep on happening through faith. Show your faith known. Make your faith known. Continue to have faith in the Father, and the Father will never let you down.